at that. Look at that golden goodness underneath this greenness here on Route 66 in Illinois. Look at that. That's corn. That's maize. Maize. Route 66, Illinois. Welcome, everybody, to another daily vlog. A vlog that happens pretty much daily, sometimes in the middle of Route 66. Well, not in the middle. It's where it starts, in Illinois. Route 66 starts up here in Illinois, ends all the way over on the west coast in California. I'm stopped here getting some fuel. Wanted to show you guys that yellow, well, it's green, but if you peel it, it's yellow corn goodness. You guys know what corn is. Why do I have to explain it? Why do I have to explain it? But I was doing a quick walk around inspection of my vehicle while I'm getting fuel up here, getting ready to get some DEF. Check my reefer. Reefer fuel is good. Just starting my day, waking up. Well, I've been awake for a little while, but not really woken up. I haven't even done my morning duties yet. My morning, not duty, duties. I haven't done my morning duties yet. In the process of getting some fuel, going inside, taking care of my morning duties, and heading on down the road. Heading down the road to Atlanta, Georgia, seeing what could possibly go wrong today. Like, I can't get my gloves on, but that's not wrong. I don't know how much fuel I'm supposed to be getting. I should have looked. I'm going to stop it at 135. Stop. We'll overtake that out of the fuel tank on the opposite side of my truck. Hang up the pumps, get some DEF fluid, and see here. Near you. Get some DEF, go inside, get some coffee. I should have got some coffee earlier this morning when I left, but I didn't. I've been working with no coffee. Working with no coffee. Have you ever heard of such a thing? No. Come on, go, go, go. I was actually thinking today to do today's daily vlogs all with my Osmo, but that is not going to happen. Basically because, let's see, that's done here. Basically because I don't think the Osmo is meant for that out of the box. You know, if I had the tripod and everything else, I'd probably be able to do that, but I don't have the tripod, and I don't want to lay my Osmo down when I'm not recording segments for the daily vlog, just because it does have a robotic three-axis gimbal. I don't want to mess that gimbal up. So when I use the Osmo, I usually take it out, shoot with it, and then disassemble it, put it back in its case, and then when I want to reuse it, I take it out of the case, reassemble it, and do that. And it kind of becomes, at least for a daily continuous vlog like this, not a hassle. It's not a hassle. It's just something you can't do and drive, or stuff like this. It's not meant for that, I don't think. And so it is daily, my daily devices, like my phones and stuff like that, they are the driver. They are the driving force of the daily vlog. I'm gonna put maybe, let's go for 7 gallons, because I'm sitting here doing the pee-pee dance. Doing the pee-pee dance. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Hurry, hurry. 1 more gallon. This thing pumps slow. Slow. Look at this. Look at this. If I didn't have to go bathroom, it probably would not seem so slow. Ah, that's good. 7 gallons. 7. Get in there, you. I hate this stuff. Hate it. Don't know why they even invented it. All it basically is urine. It's urine painted blue. Well, not painted blue. It's urine dyed blue. I don't know. I could go bathroom
in there and it would work.
It's the same substance, same thing as urine, and it supposedly keeps the pollution down. I don't know, it's weird, but I guess it's not really too good for the motors. They kind of jumped the gun on it. But let me go ahead and write down my fuel and everything else, and then I'm going to pull forward, go in, use the bathroom, and head on down the road. Maybe there is, I forget what town it is, but not too far down the road next to a Route 66 roadside attraction that I normally stop at called the Pink Elephant, which is an antique store. Just before there, I believe, there's a Route 66 museum. I've seen signs for it before. I don't know if I can get my truck into it. I just passed one up here by Springfield, Illinois, a Route 66 museum, and it looked like it was down a long dirt road. I could see the building, see the parking lot. There's no way I could have got my truck in there, but for future reference, I do know it's there, so maybe there's going to be one day I can hit that. And I'm not sure about the one down the road this way, if I could get my truck in, but I am going to be looking at that today. And if I do enter the Route 66 museum in that town, I don't know the name of the town, but I will be using the Osmo for that and incorporating the video into this daily vlog. All right, let me go ahead. I got work to do. I'll talk to you guys in a few. This is normally my Route 66 exit. Route 66 is this exit. I'm not gonna take it today. I'm just gonna run parallel. Just run parallel to it today, not really venture off too much. I tried to go to the museum in Litchfield, but I couldn't get in there. The parking lot was packed up, but I do know where it is now, and on my next trip, hopefully, maybe next week, I'll be able to venture in, but not today. See that little side road over there? That's Route 66. And one of the roadside attractions I normally stop at is right there. Right there. Look at that. Building of awesomeness. But not stopping today. Trying to get to Atlanta as fast as possible. Well, I have a little bit of time to kill. Gonna take my 30-minute break. I'm off of Route 66 and I am in Ren Lake, Illinois. So I figured, what should I do while I'm out here at Ren Lake? Well, actually, this area is the site of some of the images from one of Curtis's books. I'll show you here over here. It's not the Healthy Things book. It's just the Curtis Alphabet book. One of the first books with Curtis. I used this playground right over here for some of the images that we used in the books. And I figured, how much fun would it be to come over here right beside this beautiful lake and fly Bad Wolf. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna head over here by the lake and fly Bad Wolf, get some 4K images, and then I'm gonna go back to the truck and probably grab the Osmo and do some walking around, because there's some nice bridges over here I actually used in some of the black and white photos I sell on my website. So I'm gonna walk around there with the Osmo and shoot some 4K video there, shoot some 4K video from my drone, and create more content that I could practice with editing on my computer, because I really don't have much content to practice with. And who knows? I mean, I could even add some of this to today's vlog, the daily vlog, but not in 4K, because this is gonna be uploaded in 720p, but the 4K footage is something I'm actually going to use to practice on. So I'm thinking right over here by the lake. It's a little bit breezy, and my Phantom has been acting strange lately. So I gotta be careful, not just because of the wind, but because I'm gonna be flying over water, which, if the drone is acting funny, I don't know if it's a great idea, so I don't know how far out over the lake or how high I'm gonna go, but I'm gonna do it anyway. I'm gonna do it anyway. So let's take this thing up in the air. Okay, drone back in the truck. So that little musical montage that you're seeing now, I was out having some fun flying over the lake. I actually took it up about 400 feet up in a high wind. Well, it's not really high wind here. It's probably about 8 or 9 miles an hour, but I'm sure up there it's a lot windier than it is down here. But walking back to my truck, which I have 10 minutes left of my 30 minute drive time left, found something unique. Found something pretty unique. So check this out. Check this out. What in the heck is that? What is that? Those aren't mushrooms, but I guess they are mushrooms. But at one time it was a tree. It's no longer a tree. Now it's mushrooms. Now it's mushrooms. So what I wanted to do now is kind of walk around this rest area. Hopefully my mic is picking this up. I'm still practicing with the Osmo, and I'm shooting this in 4K so I could practice uploading onto my computer and editing. But you're gonna see this in 720p. I apologize, just because I'm gonna blend this in with my camera footage from my telephone of the stuff I've been shooting so far today. It's gonna be one of those days. Not a bad day. It's not going to be a bad day at all, but it's just going to be one of those hot, sweltering Illinois heat type days. And check this out. Check this out over here. More downed trees that somebody decided they should make the stumps look like mushrooms. Check this out. Over here, we got more stumps. See that? Look at that. A little bit unique, a little bit different. Stuff I've never seen before. Never seen people wood carve the stumps. What a great idea. Most people just cut the stumps down to the ground or pull them out. Here in Illinois, they decide to make them a work of art, a work of nature. And over here is the playground featured in one of Curtis's books. Me and Curtis walked around here and took quite a few photographs about a year or two ago on Curtis's very first book, on the introduction of Curtis. All done with Google Glass. Now I'm coming back with new technology, the Osmo, recording video, and probably taking a picture here and there of this famous historical landmark. Famous historical landmark. Due to Curtis. I don't know if anybody remembers that bus, but I put Curtis in that window. Actually, this teeter-totter over here, I put Curtis on one end and sat on the other. His weight was not enough to get me up in the air. And this bridge.
This place brings back a lot of memories because I was doing black and white photography, printing up the pictures on cotton canvas and framing them and selling them on my website. And this bridge was probably one of my most favorite photographs that I took, other than the waterfalls when I was out in Oregon. But look at that. Fairly picturesque, especially this time of year. And now I get to walk this bridge with a new piece of technology. With a new piece of technology, the Osmo. I love it. Now, later this week, I'm assuming that my accessories, more accessories are going to come. So I'm going to have that Z-axis, the big thing that stabilizes the movement up and down. So if you see, you're seeing me go up and down, I guess, kind of. And the bridge staying steady. Well, all that up and down movement is actually going to change. Let's see. Change back camera. There we go. All that is going to change soon. I'm excited about it. I got that coming. A car mount, so I'll be able to actually mount this camera on the hood of my motorcycle or the front of the tractor trailer. How awesome is that going to be? I think that's going to add a whole new look and depth to the videos. Now I just need more content. Now I got the equipment. Now it's just more content. And I also got to learn to look at you guys more than the display down here at the bottom, because I end up talking to myself. I'm looking at myself when I should be looking at you guys. It's something weird you got to get over. But if you look over here, there's the lake where I just flown the drone. Now I'm heading back to the truck and I'm going to save these videos, save them, and get ready to upload tonight and probably pretty much end today's daily vlog and start looking into an almost daily vlog. I need to find a place, probably on top of Mount Eagle. There's a lot of waterfalls, natural waterfalls and stuff. I'd like to document those for an almost daily vlog. But as for the daily vlog, I think this is about it for today. Just about it. So until the next one, guys, I will talk to you all later from Rend Lake, Illinois. Rend Lake, right over there, right behind me. It's right there somewhere. Everything is backwards on camera when you're looking at yourself. But from Rend Lake and these giant magic mushrooms, I will talk to you all in the next one. Peace.